Season 9 has unearthed a world of new skins with the future. And while we can't bring you all our Season 9 skins video just yet, we got a lot of you guys asking us to rank the Battle Pass skins, and to be honest with you, I'm pretty excited because as much as I fear any game taking a futuristic route, the skins that they came out with for Season 9 are actually really sick. I mean, you can literally play as a mecha chicken. Come on! Be sure to use code T5G in the item shop if you do decide to buy the Battle Pass or any of the skins on this list because it helps support the channel. But mostly because of the fact that I can play as a hip young teenage girl in Fortnite. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is a segment that we like to call
That's Not Weird At All. Okay, it's kind of weird.
Number 10, Stratus. Stratus is the skin that can be earned in the 71st tier of Season 9's Battle Pass. The skin is quite a simple one, putting Spitfire into a mix of ghetto and hipster clothing. He was first spotted in the third and final teaser for Season 9 that was released a day before the season came out. Stratus's headphones are dark purple and include a glowing lightning bolt, which is a reference to Save the World, Fortnite's primary game mode. On his sleeve, you can see patches which involve a skull and also a smaller one which just says easy. So the guy's a bit toxic, eh? To complete the look, Stratus has an animated scanner on his forearm, which has a radar of the Battle Royale map on it. Unfortunately, it doesn't have any variants, but you can complete challenges to unlock the Tailwind Twister Glider and Backtrack Backbling. In case you have no idea what Fort Bites are, here's a summary. Fort Bites are a list of 100 challenges which reveal part of a mystery as more are collected. You also unlock rewards along the way. Collecting 90 Fort Bites will unlock a legendary mystery item which has yet to be revealed. Probably be the secret skin of the season. They're supposed to last players all season, so get ready to be putting a lot of time into earning these things. Number 9 is Vega. Vega is an outfit that can be earned in the 47th tier of Season 9's Battle Pass. She's sort of a futuristic version of Calamity, with her fancy revolver holster and a modern cowgirl-esque design. She was not revealed in any teasers before the season launched, but she can be spotted at the end of the opening cinematic, along with the other Battle Pass skins. Vega is a part of the Bounty Hunter set and comes with three styles. Her default look, a red style option, and a teal style. You can unlock her additional styles by completing challenges. To unlock her red variant, you must reach tier 47 and then outlast 7,500 opponents playing Battle Royale. That's equivalent to winning 75 solo games. Damn. Not only that, but you've got to collect 54 bites in order to get her teal variant. Vega's challenges also include opportunities to get the Go Bag Backbling and the Revoker Pickaxe. To get the back bling, you've got to outlast 2,500 opponents in Battle Royale, so not as hard as getting something as simple as a different color. And to get her pickaxe, which I personally think looks dope, you've got to collect 55 Fort Bites. I'm sensing that if you've collected all 100 Fort Bites by the end of Season 9, then you're going to have a lot of items for free, because all of these challenges have to do with these Fort Bite things. I don't know if I'm into it or not, but let us know what you think about them. Number 8 is Sentinel. Sentinel is a base skin that you unlock the second you buy the Season 9 Battle Pass, as it's at the very first tier. Tier 1 also comes with a 60% friend XP boost and a ton of challenges for you to do. Let's get into that. Sentinel is a part of the Battle Dynamics set, and it's a really cool looking skin which mashes a classic Transformer action figure with, well, the chicken. Either way, Sentinel is pretty much a cookie cutter skin. There's nothing too special about his normal variant other than some cool robot-like animations and the fact that he's a robot chicken. Man, I love that show. With Sentinel's challenges, you get the chance to unlock the legendary Hot Wing Backbling, a Sentinel banner, and a Jump Jets emote. You get the banner from completing both the other two challenges. To get the Backbling, you've got to collect 10 Fort Bites, and you got to get 20 Fort Bites for the emote. Sensing a pattern? Yeah, me too. I wonder what level of heat this guy is on Hot Ones. Number 7. Vendetta. Vendetta is a skin that you unlock by completing all 100 tiers of the Season 9 Battle Pass. Like many other tier 100 skins before him, he comes with a ton of challenges and variants. Part of the suit-up set, Vendetta's Stage 1 look is just your average hipster with dyed white hair, an oversized hoodie, and some basic trousers. At face value, not too impressive for something that is at the very end of the Battle Pass, but it's a pretty cool skin, and you don't have to even upgrade it for it to get to that point. Vendetta comes with multiple styles, to change his hood or sometimes his whole hoodie. Yeah, if you want a different color, you gotta do challenges, apparently. You want an orange hood, you gotta complete 45 weekly challenges. If you want Vendetta's light orange hoodie, you gotta do 65 weekly challenges. A neon blue hood is given for outlasting 1,000 opponents, dark gray jacket is outlasting 10,000 opponents, neon green hood is collecting 84 bites, and finally a white hoodie is given for collecting 85 Fort Bites, yada yada yada. A lot of work for just a different shirt or hood color, right? Vendetta comes with a mech axe pickaxe. Wow, say that like 5 times in a row. I'm already done. Which can be earned by outlasting 5,000 opponents and a Retribution Backbling, which you can add to your locker by completing 55 weekly challenges. Number 6 is the Rox. Rox is a skin that you can also get in the first tier of Season 9's Battle Pass, and many have come to believe was a skin made after the YouTuber Loserfruit. Part of the Sky Style set, Rox wears a short skirt, fingerless gloves, long colorful socks, and a leather jacket with subtle suspenders. She comes with quite a few styles that are more than just changing the color of a hood, Vendetta. You can collect four bites to earn a yellow style, an orange style, a green style, and a black style. They actually look really dope on the Stage 1 version of Rock. If you complete 10 weekly challenges, you can unlock a blue style while completing 20 weekly challenges, which will give you a special peace out emote. The best thing about Rock's challenges is that collecting 45 fork bites will give you two pickaxes. Yep, a neat new addition in Season 9 is that some pickaxes will be a duo. Rox's pickaxe, called the Harmonic Axes, are a hell of a pair. They look insane, and while they don't mine faster because then it would be a pay-to-win, and that would not be good because you guys know how the pay-to-wins work. People get mad, I get mad, grandmother gets mad. They certainly look awesome when harvesting materials. I gotta say, Rox is one of my favorite Tier 1 skins, and Fortnite made a cool-looking one with her. She comes with five upgradable styles, but I'll get into that later. Number five, Sentinel, the dark version. Yet we're ranking some styles of skins separately to the base outfit because some styles are just too awesome to be dragged down by a trash Stage 1 look. While Sentinel being a damn chicken was hilarious and is pretty cool in of itself, you can unlock a dark style for the skin by reaching Tier 99 of the Season 9 Battle Pass. You can't unlock Dark Sentinel with a challenge. You actually have to reach Tier 99, which makes this outfit even more cool. Instead of just a color change, this style grabs the Omega and Oblivion skins and mixes them with the Stage 1 Sentinel outfit. As a result, you get a black painted Sentinel with neon orange lights, normal robot feet instead of three claws, and the Omega helmet is just, it's a cool nod putting an Omega or Oblivion style for Sentinel in Tier 99 because the original Omega skin was the Tier 100 outfit that could be gained in Season 4's Battle Pass. Maybe him coming back is hinting at a return of superheroes. Maybe. We'll have to see. I mean, where did the rocket go anyway? I love the chicken skin, but this one's pretty dope, and I would say worth the grind to get Tier 99 unless you buy the entire pass in one day. But I don't judge. Number four, Demi. Demi's a skin that can be unlocked by reaching Tier 87 of the Season 9 Battle Pass. Armed with the power of a dragon and part of the Scarlet Dragon set, this outfit is straight fire. I mean, Demi has all sorts of features for a skin that looks pretty basic at a distance. I mean, she has a red stripe in her hair, also wears a red and black gaming headset. She has a sleeve tattoo which shows a dragon. Looks cool, but then you zoom into it and realize that the dragon's got this derpy face. It's just like, what the heck is going on? She also wears a short-fitted red Kai Pao dress. That was probably offensively pronounced, although that isn't the main attraction of the outfit. Demi has a bionicle red arm that looks literally like Iron Man's suit, but as a replacement for an amputated arm, we still have yet to know what her backstory is that made her lose her arm. But maybe we'll find out in the future. Future! If you collect 74 bites, you can unlock Demi's Scarlet Scythe pickaxe, which looks oddly similar to Drift's pickaxe. By collecting 75 fort bites, you win the Scarlet Edge Backbling, which is two curved daggers that seem to be on fire.
I mean, I did say it was straight fire. I mean, you want to roll it back?
Number three, Bunker Jonesy. Bunker Jonesy is the skin unlocked in the 23rd tier of Season 9's Battle Pass. He's one of those really ridiculous skins that Fortnite add every season just for a laugh. You can put him next to Giddy Up, Peely, Trog, and others. Speaking of Peely, they actually gave Bunker Jonesy a full-on backstory in the opening cinematic to Season 9. During Season 8, the volcano erupted, causing balls of lava to rain down upon locations such as Retail Row and Tilted Tower. In the cutscene, you see a regular Jonesy and Peely run from the devastation and take refuge in a safe bunker. It's a pretty funny video if you haven't seen it yet, but they realize they have no food in the fridge. Spoiler alert, Bunker Jonesy, and this is pretty dark when you think about it, turns Peely into a smoothie and drinks him to stay alive. Because of this, Bunker Jonesy as a skin has an extremely long beard from however long he spent in the bunker, as well as some morbid paint on his arm that says, "I am banana," on his leg. You can see the Nana Nana sticker, which was on Peely. It's obviously now on him. Fortnite is a game for all family to play. It's a bit dark that Jonesy murdered Peely and turned him into a smoothie. Poor dude. It gets even worse, though. With challenges, you can unlock the Ride Ripper's dual pickaxe set by collecting 30 fort bites. And get this, a Nana cape for 40 fort bites. Yep, Jonesy practically skinned Peely live and turned his skin into a cape to wear. The description is a Peely original. Why is this so dark, Epic Games? It really didn't have to get that dark. This game is rated E for everyone, is it not? Either way, it's a really cool comical skin and I really enjoy it. Good job, guys. Good job. Number two, Rox Stage 5. Rox's fifth and final stage that you can upgrade to is an insanely cool one. I mean, first revealed in the second teaser for Season 9 prior to release, her outfit turns from a hip-hop woman to a futuristic soldier. Rox's fifth stage is a mashup
of Tracer from Overwatch and Proto Man from Mega Man. The neon blue on her legs paired with the sweet helmet and visor make for a brilliant skin, which will have players running to obtain. You can get the fifth stage by unlocking rocks through tier one of the battle pass and then earning a whopping 200,000 XP. There's no deadline for doing so though, so take all the time you need. But in at number one, we've got the Vendetta Stage 5. Vendetta's fifth and final stage is the best skin in the Fortnite Battle Pass, and it sits at number one on our list as well as tier 100 in the past for an excellent reason. When Vendetta was first shown in the first ever teaser for Season 9, it gained some interest among those wanting to know more. Now that we have a playable game, there's a very good reason why he sits at the top. The fifth stage for Vendetta adds a ton of armor to the previously hip outfit, as well as giving him a sweet robot helmet and blue fire on his feet and shoulders. You can unlock the fifth stage by getting to tier 100 in the pass and then gaining 250,000 XP, similar to Rocks and any other skin with upgradable stages. But that has been our list of the top 10 new Season 9 Fortnite skins, ranked from worst to best. Be sure to click that like button if you've enjoyed. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. Push notifications on. Be sure to use code D5G in the item shop if you guys end up getting the battle pass or any of these cosmetics. Also, join the Discord because we're going to be doing all sorts of stuff for Season 9 over there. With that being said, we hope you have a wonderful day and keep it here on Top 5 Gaming.